So today we will do the time domain response from the whole Zerox block. In the last class, I have already dictated you that first of all, you may be given any response either IS or BS. Okay, or you can be given a circuit also. Is it clear? So from that circuit, you may be asked find out IT using whole Zerox block. Okay, so first of all, you will frame what? First step. Second step, now you will be partially fractionalizing. Okay, so you will get something in this form k1 upon s plus p1 plus k2 upon s plus p2 like this. Now come the real matter. Now you have to evaluate what is k1, k2 are known as residues. What they are known as residues. You have to evaluate this k1, k2 with the help of whole zero. So write out the numerical related to it, which will make you the concept more understandable. So the current IS in the network is given as the current IS in the network has given as 2s upon s plus 1 s plus. Clear? So what is the first step? First step is partially fractionalizing. So that will be k1 s plus 1 and another will be k2 upon. Before that, or after that also, you can draw the whole zero diagram. So you will take a graph paper, or the graph from the center of the graph paper, you will draw two lines, one horizontal and another vertical. Horizontal line representing negative real, or sorry, real axis, and the vertical line imaginary axis. You will choose the suitable scale. Choose a suitable scale. Mind it. Here a gain factor is there too. You have to write down gain factor here. Gain factor is how much? Clear? Is it not? Now plot the whole zero. How many zeros are there?
One.
Existing at?
Zero.
X is equal to?
Zero.
Zero at the origin. So I will draw zero here at the center. Yes. Clear?
Yes.
How many poles?
Two.
Two poles. S is equal to?
Minus 1
and S is equal to?
Minus 2.
So, let us, this is the negative real axis. This is say -1 and this is say -2. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
This is the whole form of a given IS. Now I have to find out K1. K1 corresponds to the residue of? S is equal to?
-1.
S is equal to?
-1.
So what is my formula? Formula is k1 is equal to
h is equal to
h. H is how much?
2.
Multiply by the product of the phasor of each zero from pole under consideration. Pole under consideration is which one? H is equal to -1. So first of all, how much is this distance?
1.
How much angle this 0 is making?
180.
How much?
180.
So 2 into 1 angle 180 degrees. Now any more 0?
No.
Divided by phase product of the phasors of other pole from the pole under consideration. Pole under consideration is -1. How much is this distance?
1.
How much this angle?
Zero.
So it will be one angle. So what is the answer?
180
degrees. Which is also equal to
minus.
Am I correct?
Yes.
So you can write down. Or we will write down. First evaluate. Now I have to evaluate what? K2. What is K2? Now for K2 is the residue of pole under consideration, S is equal to minus 2. So everything is to be minus 2. So first of all, A2 will be scale factor 2. Multiply by product of the phasors of all zero with respect to whole under concentration. Whole under concentration is minus 2. How much is the distance?
2.
How much is distance?
2.
Angle?
180.
Angle?
180.
Sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is 2 angle 180. Any angle? 0? So now pole. Pole under concentration is this. So that one is this one. How much is the distance?
1.
How much angle this is making?
180.
So 1 angle?
180.
So what is the answer?
4.
You got my point? So K1 and K2 we have evaluated. So in the next step we will write down how much it is? Minus 2. And how much it is?
4.
4. Now what is the next step?
Take inverse
Laplace transform. So how much it comes out to be? Minus 2 e raised to power minus 3 plus 4 e raised to power minus 2. You got my point? So this is the solution. You can verify it also by your conventional method. Okay, for example, I want to evaluate s is equal to, if I take s is equal to minus 1, except at s plus 1, then what I will get? 2 minus 1, 1, and 2 into minus 1, minus 2. Minus 2 upon 1 is minus 2, the same result. Similarly, if I substitute s is equal to minus 2, what I will get? Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1, and 2 into minus 2. Minus 4 divided by minus 1, 4, we are getting the same result. You can check it also. Is it clear? You take another numerical. The voltage Vs of a network is given as you have to evaluate K1 K1, K2 and K3. Let us evaluate K1. K1 corresponds to residue 2, S is equal to minus 2. Do you agree or not? So, what is the formula? K1. First of all, evaluate K1. H is how much?
3.
3, okay. Now, product of the phasors of all zeros from the pole under consideration. So, what is this?
This is 4.
This is only 0. And this is the pole under consideration. How much is this length?
2.
How much angle?
180.
Multiply by 2 angles. Any other 0?
No.
Now we will take the poles. How many poles left?
2.
2. Okay. So first of all I will take this pole. How much is this distance?
Root 2.
Yes?
Root 2.
How you find? Trigonometry. Okay? How? Just draw a triangle. Now don't draw it, just assume this is a triangle. How much is this distance? Base length?
1.
Perpendicular?
1.
So I put it in under root 1 square plus 1 square. So its length is how much?
2.
So magnitude of this phasor comes out to be 2. Is it clear or not? What is the next step?
Angle.
How much you have to find out? Angle. So what you do? Same angle is this much? Clear or not? Okay. 1, 1. So tan inverse. So tan theta is equal to 1/1. So theta is equal to tan inverse 1. And tan inverse 1 is nothing but 45. So theta comes out to be 45. So how much angle? Root angle? Root 2 angle? And is it clear or not? Okay. Any more? Yes. This pole is to be also into consideration. Is it not? Okay. So, how much length?
Root
2. Same length, root 2. Now, there will be change in angle. Mind it. How much will be the angle? How much? Minus? Anybody more?
2
Sure? Or just Utka? 135. Anybody say 135?
Sir, 225.
225. Any more? The correct answer is 135. How? See? The angle here. Is it clear? How much angle is it? So I will draw. If there is any confusion, just draw the frame of reference. 4 quadrants. I am drawing here. Clear? You got my point or not? Now I have to find out this angle. Because the angle is always in the anticlockwise direction from the zero reference. From the zero reference. Now you have found out this angle. 45 degrees, is it not? By the trigonometry law, you have found out this angle is? But I am interested in which angle? This angle. You got my point or not? So how much is this? 90 plus 45 it comes out to be?
Sir, yes. Sir, the previous one should be 225.
From this
one. Previous one, yes.
225.
Yes. Sorry. The previous one should be 225. Yes, very correct. He is very correct. Previous one should be 225 because if this angle is 45, this angle is also 45. But if you draw the reference, how much is this?
90.
How much is this? 180 degree. 180 degree plus 45?
225.
So it is not 45, it is how much?
225.
You got my point or not?
Yes,
sir. Similarly, for this angle, how much is this?
135.
So, root 2 angle 1. Now, solve it, how much you are getting? Yes, how much you are getting?
Minus 3.
Three angle 180 degree everybody is getting?
Yes sir.
And three angle 180 degree how much? minus 3. So K1 comes out to be minus 3. Is that correct? Is this confusion is clear? This 2, this is not 45, this is 225 degrees. Because if you will draw the reference here, this is 90, this is 180 degrees, this is 180 degrees plus 45, that is 225. Or you can also write down minus 125 degrees. But don't get confused, always use the anti-clockwise direction as a reference, so it should be 225. Is there any problem? Malam? Is there any problem in this?
No.
So, K1, now let's talk about another, K2. So, when K2 is considered, which root will come into play? This pole will be under consideration, is it not? Minus 1 plus? Do you agree or not? Okay. So, now I will find out, first of all, 3 multiply by how much distance? How much distance? Root 2. Everybody agrees? Okay, very fine. Or how much angle? Now see. This angle is 45. But we have to find out this angle from this reference. Is it clear? So, how much is 90 plus 45? How much it is? 1? So, it is 135. Any more zero? No. Now, I have to find out the angle phasor from this pole to this pole. How much is distance? How much is distance?
Root 2.
Sure. And what about the angle?
45.
Everybody agrees?
Yes.
See, I have to draw a reference here. Okay. How much this angle is remaining? How much this angle is remaining? 45. So it is root 2 angle 45. Now this. How much is this? Distance between them is?
2.
This is 1. This is 1. How much?
2.
Okay. And how much angle?
90.
How much angle?
90.
Sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 90 degrees. See, if I draw the reference, then this is drawing this like 90 degrees. Clear? So now solve it. How much is this coming?
3 by 2.
Yes, 3 by 2. Clear or not? Now next. K3. Now, before evaluating K3, I will like to mention one important point, that whenever there is a complex conjugate, poles are there, then no doubt we will evaluate it by mathematics, but you will find that the residue of K3 is nothing but the complex conjugate of K2. Complex conjugate of K2. Is it clear? So whenever there is a complex conjugate pole is there, you evaluate the first one residue and then take the complex conjugate of the first one, that will be the residue of the second one. So in this case, how much is the residue? If you take the complex conjugate of 3 by 2, it will be how much?
3 by 2.
Because in complex conjugate, the imaginary part sign changes, but not the real part. So it will come out to be 3 by 2. This is just a trick I have given you. But for your convenience, you can evaluate also to verify. Let us check. Again, K3. How much? 3. Now, first of all, I have to find out phasor from the 0. How much this length? How much this length?
Root 2.
Okay. How much this angle is framing? No, sorry. How much this angle is framing?
225.
Correct. Angle 225. Upon. No more 0, only 4. Okay. First of all, find out the distance. How much this distance?
Root 2.
Okay. Angle. How much this angle is making?
125.
How much this angle is making?
115
degrees. This is pole under consideration. I have to find this angle. If I draw a line, this is minus 45 degrees. Or 180 degree. Rather than we generally say minus 45 degree. Because it is clockwise direction. Is it clear? So it will be root 2 angle minus 45 degree. Okay. What else? Now this is left. How much is this distance?
2.
2. Okay. And how much angle? How much angle? 270 degree or minus 90 degree. Solve it. How much is this coming?
3 by 2.
Is it not or is it clear?
Yes,
how much is coming?
3 by 2.
Is it clear? Or if you don't want to waste time, then evaluate for K2, take its complex conjugate, and that will be the residue of the K3.
So how to go minus 45?
See, for us a zoom, I will zoom this whole thing. Okay? For better understand. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This was at minus 2. Okay? And this was at minus 1 plus minus 1 minus 2. Is it clear? So I will draw a triangle C. Are you seeing? Is it clear? I am interested in this angle. Now I will draw a reference here. If I will move like this, anti-clockwise direction. Okay? But my angle is this much. Is it clear? So if I move in clockwise direction, all angles will be of same magnitude but of negative value. For example, if this is angle, this is plus 45 degree. And this is?
Minus 45.
And that is by minus 45. Or, those who don't understand the clockwise, anti-clockwise, and simple anti-clockwise direction, then they can take this angle. How much is this? 300? 90, 180, 270, plus 45, how much? 315. The answer will be same.
It's about minus 90.
Yes, okay, I will again zoom that problem. Zoom that diagram. This is there. Okay? Distance is clear? Now I draw a reference here. This is angle is how much? Plus 90 degree. This is how much?
Minus
90 degree or 270 degree. So instead of 270, I have written, since this is below. So this is minus 90. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just you have to, where you have to calculate the phasor, and there you have to put your frame of reference. Then horizontal line and vertical line you can calculate. You will never get confused. Clear or not? So, two problems have been taken into account. Likewise, you solve more and more problems. Okay? The concept is same. We have taken the two problems, one is the single simple pole and simple zero, and another complex poles we have taken. Is that clear? So, every year there used to be a one numerical on this. Is it clear? So get prepared, do more and more practice of this type of numericals, you will get the marks. That's all for today.